This is YouTube. It first appeared on the World Wide Web in 2005, featuring a quite unfamiliar design. This is an iMac G3 with a 333 MHz PowerPC processor sold in 1999 for $1,199. That's equivalent to about $1,900 in 2021. Despite all the work I put into getting this connected to the internet, I wasn't able to watch YouTube. That shouldn't be surprising considering YouTube was born 6 years after this computer, and hardly anyone had an internet connection fast enough to stream video anyways. But what if we could have YouTube in 1999, and have it actually play on my iMac? We would need to figure out how to get video to play on such an old system, and also figure out what it should look like. I did some research by checking out what some popular websites looked like back in 1999.
Start with Alta Vista. Alright, well, this looks actually not too bad. Obviously it has a really narrow design. Nope, that's too modern. 2099. Got our stock quotes. This was right before .com bust. Cool. Very narrow web page. Wow, filing taxes online, the antitrust trial, right? Okay, I think we've seen enough of that. Ah yes, QuickTime 4. Hey, look, there's my iMac. Still, only $11.99, wow. Ooh, the iBook. I mean, I think even today, like, the iBook still looks very nice, and Airport. Ooh, they even preserved the banner ads. You know, it's really amazing how little has changed compared to how much has changed back then.
Based on this scientific research, I've concluded that I need to incorporate these three design elements. Number one, the web page needs to be sized for 800 by 600 resolution. Don't want to risk having content that's too wide for your visitors. Number two, all of the links have to be blue, or else people don't know their links. Number three, button images with fake 3D bevels. This is to discourage blind people from browsing your website. Of course, to design the website, I needed period-correct software, so I brought out my Windows 98 CD-ROM and installed it into a virtual machine. Next was installing Photoshop. Not Photoshop CS5, but Photoshop 5.5. As you can see, the only thing that's changed about Photoshop in the last 20 years is the addition of dark mode. Gotta start with an 800 by 600 template, and then make sure that everything has some sort of drop shadow or bevel effect to give it that fake 3D feel. You know, I take back what I said about nothing changing in Photoshop, because it wasn't until Photoshop 6 that they introduced the rounded rectangle tool. I also need to explain that back in the 90s and well into the 2000s, many websites were laid out using tables. If you wanted a fancy design, what you did was slice up your design into multiple pieces and then put one image in each table cell. Eventually, they decided that this made it too easy for people to make web pages, so they invented CSS and the rest is history. Also critical to web design is the idea of a rollover image. You simply wrote some JavaScript that swapped the image for an alternate image when the mouse moves over it. Sure, it would look broken until your visitor loaded the alternate image using their 56k modem, but after the first load, it would look pretty good. The real magic here is that ImageReady will not only slice your image, but also generate the HTML and JavaScript for you, including links and rollovers. I apparently don't know how to use ImageReady and the buttons all simultaneously swap, but I've learned a little JavaScript over the last 20 years, so I figured out how to fix it manually. Returning to the year 2021, I took my template and hooked it up to some Python code. It can handle the watch URL, grab the video info using YouTube DL, and show the title and description as well as the embedded player. But that's not going to fly in 1999 considering the video codecs that YouTube uses. Instead, I have QuickTime version 4 running as a plugin inside Internet Explorer 5 for Mac, and I need to figure out how to convert YouTube videos into a format that QuickTime will play. I didn't expect it, but this was by far and away the hardest part of this whole project. I searched through the graveyard of obsolete codecs full of names like Cinepak, Indio, Sorensen, QDesign Music, all these proprietary codecs that had to be perfectly matched with the right container and right plugin. You had to purchase RealPlayer's encoding software to make RealPlayer files, Windows Media Encoder for Windows Media Video, and QuickTime Pro for QuickTime files. If you tried making a video file on your own and deviated even a little from what the media player wanted, it wouldn't work. In the end, I tried more than 50 different combinations of video and audio codecs in different containers. Some didn't play at all. Some crashed my computer. Some only worked in QuickTime outside of the browser. And some had video artifacts or garbled audio. I was so desperate that I even looked for help in a paper book. Finally, I found a simple combination that worked. MPEG-1 video with MP2 audio in an MPEG container with the audio bitrate and sample rate exactly to spec. And it worked. I put two quality options on there to be friendly to those dial-up users. Let's just take a moment to appreciate this very 90s video.
Hello, I'm Bill Gates, Chairman of Microsoft. In this video, you're going to see the future, Windows. Microsoft first came up with the Windows concept back in 1983. And today, the leading software users have switched into the Windows environment.
If we click around to the links on the side, you can see I've collected some era-appropriate videos. Let's take a look at gaming, too. Here's Steve Jobs announcing this new Mac game from Bungie. It's called Halo, and it looks pretty sick. Hope it comes out soon.
We are starting to see some great games come back to the Mac, but this is one of the coolest I've ever seen. This game is going to ship early next year from Bungie, and this is the first time anybody has ever seen it. It's the first time they've debuted it. And so I'm very happy to welcome on the stage Jason Jones, who is the co-founder of Bungie and the Halo project lead. Halo is the name of this game, and we're going to see, for the first time, Halo. Welcome, Jason.
Thanks, Steve. Yeah. Everything you're about to see is being rendered in real time on a Macintosh using OpenGL.
The last feature I added was the very important YouTube view counter in an appropriately 90s format. Now, I wish I could put 90s Tube on a public site for all of you OS 9 and Windows 98 users, but because of how it downloads and transcodes the videos, it would probably get banned by YouTube pretty quickly. If you do want to try it out, there's a link in the description for a download of the source code, which probably only runs on Linux. Hope you enjoyed traveling back in time with me to the 90s, and feel free to throw out ideas for other things to do with my iMac. Thanks for watching. Thank you.